Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the channel. I am Adam Bilsing, and this is Dirty Bandana Music. And today we're going to talk about a cool drum trend that's been going around the internet for a while now. The Everybody Wants to Rule the World Drum Challenge. Okay, so if you've seen any of these videos floating around, you already know this challenge is based around the song Everybody Wants to Rule the World by Tears for Fears. Now this is a pretty cool track and already kind of a nice drum groove. It's a 12/8 style groove with sort of a quarter note triplets accent in the right hand on the hi-hat, which at 112 beats per minute, which is where our goal is today, that's already kind of a challenging groove in itself. But this challenge on the internet that everybody's doing is based around some metric modulation concepts that we talked about a couple weeks ago. Links below for that video. And what happens with this one is we're basically going to metrically modulate around the eighth note triplet in the hi-hat pattern. So the song itself, the main part goes a little something like this. And the anchor that we're going to use is in the right hand on the hi-hat. So that first beat that I played is available for download on my website, dirtybandana.com. I've got the exercises that we're working through today up there. You can download them for free. So that thing I just played is exercise number one. It's a 12/8 groove with accents on the quarter note triplets in the right hand. Now, like I said, that's a little tricky to get up to tempo anyway, but what we want to focus on is the triplets in the right hand, because we're going to move into sort of a 4/3 feel based around that exact subdivision in the right hand. So essentially the way this works is that your right hand is never going to change. When I was watching these videos, I had a really hard time figuring out what was exactly going on with the metric modulation, because all the cats playing this stuff are just fantastic and they're blowing all over this thing and playing lots of crazy chops, but I was trying to figure out where the actual pulse is. So that's what we're going to talk about today. So like I said, focus on the right hand. Starting out, that's going to be triplets. But what we're gonna do is in our mind, make that 16th notes. So we're gonna go from beat number one on the examples, and we're gonna move into beat number two. So the right hand triplets stay exactly the same, but we're gonna switch the placement of the kick drum and the snare drum. It's gonna sound a little something like this. So I would practice this with the metronome at first to make sure that you're staying with those subdivisions, but try it a lot slower than 112 beats per minute, because that's going to be pretty challenging. So the other variation of these grooves that you can use if you're trying to do this metric modulation challenge with this song is that you can take that same hi-hat pulse, but remove the unaccented notes. And that's going to give us sort of a halftimey feel when we're in the 12/8 section. And then when we modulate into the new groove, it's going to turn our right hands into a very conventional eighth note on top rock groove. So that transition sounds a little something like this. And those will be exercises number 3 and 4 off of that same sheet for download from my website. So these are the basics. Now, this is still challenging even just with the basics. And if I'm being honest, I'm not ready to show off my own version of soloing over this yet. But what I tried to do to show us all an example of how this feels against the actual song is I took a swing at playing these grooves modulated with the Tears for Fears track with very minimal fills, like just the grooves, just the modulation from one to the other. So that's what we're gonna play you to finish the video with. I would encourage you to try this stuff out on your own, really internalize the triplet feel in your right hand. That's what this whole challenge is modulating around, is the triplets in your right hand. Those stay steady the whole time. So do a little practicing, get this stuff under your hands, and go ahead and take a swing at it yourself. Leave me links or tell me what you're doing. I'd love to see what you try out. That's it for this week. I'd like to, of course, thank my friends over at Red 11 Media for producing this video along with all the other content on my YouTube channel. If you'd like to follow me on the rest of the internet, you can catch me on Instagram at dirtybandana or on my website at dirtybandana.com. That's it for now. We'll see y'all next time.